A common use case of Azure is to host databases. And what we're going to look at is the main offering called Azure SQL. They call this the family of cloud databases because there's actually a couple different options. The ones we'll focus on most specifically here today are the SQL Server on a virtual machine, the managed instance, and the SQL database. At a high level, between the three of these, there's two buckets that we can put these under. One is infrastructure as a service, and the other is platform as a service. So the big difference is the level of control that you're going to have. Infrastructure as a service, you're going to have some more requirements to do more of the upgrades and configuration. You get control to the operating system, more control, more work, but potentially, if you do it right, cost savings. Meanwhile, platform as a service, all the upgrades, security, et cetera, all handled through the cloud platform. It's more managed, get some recommendations, automations built in with it. Overall, less responsibility because you're offloading some of that control, but possibly going to cost you a little bit more. Virtual machine, typically best for if you want 100% lift and shift, replace exactly what you have on the cloud with full control. Managed is going to be that full instance of SQL Server plus the benefits of a platform. And then third, database, more for the modern cloud applications, providing the most platform as a service capabilities of all the options. With that out of the way, let's go through an example of how to actually build one of these and access it. We're back here on our portal, and if we go to more services and go to databases, here we can see there's actually quite a few different options that show up here. We'll focus on that Azure SQL. So let's go ahead and create an Azure SQL resource. Right away, it's saying, which one do you want to use? And we've just discussed the differences between these. In this case, I'm going to just keep it simple and create a SQL database. We're not going to do the whole server or Elastic Pool or anything like that. We just want a single database. So let's select create subscription. We'll use the one that we have, same resource group. And now we need to give it a name, KDS SQL database server. We don't have any server yet created for this. And it's saying a logical server. So it's not necessarily a physical piece of equipment. We might be sharing it here. So let's say create new. We'll give it a server name, and you can see here it's going to be filling out this URL location. You can pick the one that's closest to you. And here we can select our preferred method for accessing this. If you have Active Directory set up, you could put this here, but right now we haven't set that up yet on our end. So what I'll do is just SQL authentication and we'll create a login here. And here you can see it can't contain certain things here. It can't have things like admin or root or SA, anything like that. Enter a password and confirm it. Okay, so now we have the name of the database, KDS SQL database, on the KDS SQL DB server. Do we want to use Elastic Pool? It's going to say no for now. And here we're talking about the compute versus storage. Let's take a look at this. What this is talking about is how we're going to actually pay for it. And here's an estimated cost per month. You can adjust this as you need, but essentially there's a difference between DTU and vCore. We'll talk about this a little bit more in a different video. Essentially, DTU is a little bit more of a straightforward cost. It's kind of a measured blend of CPU, memory, IO, all this stuff to just give you one cost, whereas vCore have a little bit of a separation between compute and storage and have a little bit more flexibility. Neither is better or worse. It's just different options. We'll just stick with this for now. I'm going to keep this as is, review and create. We'll go next, networking. And here's some other options. You can determine what kind of access you want. We're going to say no access just to start. Let's review and create. Okay, so our deployment is complete. Let's go to resource and here it is. It's set up for us, status online. Here's our server name. Here it gives you options to connect. So we can connect with Azure Data Studio, Visual Studio. And another option I'm gonna try to do is connect directly through SQL Server Management Studio. It's something that you might already have. Let's try this. Let's do server name, copy to clipboard. Here in SQL Server Management Studio for the server name, we're going to paste that in. And here, instead of Windows authentication, if you remember, we created that admin login. So let's try to log in with this here. I'm going to put that same information that I did. Let's see if this will work. Okay, so firewall rule. Your client IP does not have access. It's locking it down right away as a security feature. Because remember, we said no public access. So until we change something, no one can get in. I'm going to go sign in here. And now, because I signed in, it knows who I am. It's asking if we want to add this client IP address or add the subnet IP range. But for me, I'm just going to do the one. Now let's connect. And here we are. We're in. We're connected to this server that we created, and here is that database that we created. Not going to be anything in here. We haven't created anything, but now we could use this as if it was something we built on our own. We could open up and create a new query and create a table. And if we refresh, here we go. We have a table and it's there. It's just as if you built this on your own server in any other fashion, but now we've done this through Azure. It's only going to be that one database in this scenario because we did the SQL database. But if you move down the line to managing an instance or a VM, you would have more control over everything about this. But we can see here the database storage. We can see all this information, the compute utilization, so you can track that. Here's some more firewall rules if you need to add some information here, add a client IP. You know, here we can see mine is here. So I've been added. I could rename this and home, you know, something like that. And you could add other ones. So if you have an office or you have individuals who want to access it, you can add that as a rule, add their IP, and they'll be ready to go. At this point, you can hop around and see these different things. In future videos, we'll talk about some of these settings more in depth. But at this point, now we've created a database. You can go and create multiple databases, create a server, host a whole VM instance, and you're ready to go. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you at the next one.